LeChuck!
Guybrush!
I would have bet my good hand I'd never say this, but thank you.
For what? I've caused you nothing but despair.
For taking the fall back there, and for exposing the voodoo lady. I don't know what to make of any of it, but now I can focus on saving Elaine and dealing with the pox.
It is the very least I could do. But be careful, Guybrush.
I'm always careful.
This from the guy who proposed to his wife with the cursed engagement ring you stole from my hold.
Is that a dig? Is the evil demon pirate LeChuck developing a sense of humor? This is weird. Really, thanks again.
You don't need to thank me, my friend. I merely spoke the truth. They say that truth is the greatest barnacle scrubber, you know.
Where have you been? I thought you were with Elaine.
Well, after leaving Spinner Cave, Elaine and I set out to finish releasing all those monkeys I'd captured. After we were finished releasing the last of them, Elaine caught wind of your trial, went into a poxed rage, seized a passing clam schooner, and made a beeline for Flotsam Island.
That's my girl.
Needless to say, I took my own vessel and headed after her. But in the middle of the night, my ship was sunk by a rogue wave. I was washed up on an island of cannibals, from whom I deftly escaped using many of the self-same skills you taught me back on the Jerkbait Islands.
You know, it's amazing how easily man-eating tribes can be reasoned with.
Knowing I needed to get here more than ever, I lashed together a few bits of cannibal leftovers and warthog sinew to build a makeshift raft. Unfortunately, that was soon eaten by the sharks.
Oh no!
So I swam. I swam as fast as I could for 3 days.
And arrived just in time to save me from the gallows. Nicely done, buddy. Kudos to your swim instructor.
I was fueled by the fire of our budding friendship.
Have you seen Elaine?
No, not since she left me in a poxed rage.
She's been doing a lot of that lately. So you haven't seen Elaine, then?
I'm afraid not. She's quite a handful.
You're telling me. All those thwarted attempts to marry her might have been blessings in disguise, huh? I can't believe the voodoo lady has been pulling your ghostly slash demonic strings all these years.
It came as a shock to me as well. But her diary spells it all out. You, me, Elaine, we're all part of the voodoo lady's malevolent plans.
Malevolence is in the eye of the beholder, Guybrush Threepwood. I know this is difficult to understand, but things are not as they seem.
No, things seem remarkably convoluted, which is what I've come to expect from you.
I've always had your best interests at heart.
Well, what about my interests? Without your meddling, I could have lived a normal, happy pirate's life.
Ha! The destiny of LeChuck has never been normal.
How about the mountain of ice on the roller coaster of the dam? She was behind that?
Especially that.
I risked life, limb, and manatee to get La Esponja Grande, and it's a puny, worthless lump.
What?
Soak up the gargantuan wonder that is La Esponja Grande.
That is La Esponja Grande? But wasn't it supposed to hold infinite amounts of voodoo?
I know. What a crock.
The size of the sponge is meaningless. It is what you do with it that matters.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah?
Well, you fight like a...
The sponge is still small.
Most unfortunate.
So, Miss Spooky Pants gave me this menu which will supposedly put more grande in my esponja.
Excellent!
You wanna put some of your newfound deductive reasoning to the test and help me figure out what I need for the menu?
I'd give my beard to be able to help you, but I'm afraid my pirate mind is not fit for such things.
Explains why after all these years, you still allowed me to get within a nautical mile of you with a bottle of voodoo root beer. Got any deep thoughts about this voodoo menu?
I'm afraid I'm useless here, Guybrush.
Sit tight, buddy. Once I save Elaine, you're next.
Don't worry about me.
Stan!
Threepwood! No hard feelings over all those various civil and criminal charges?
Water under the bridge.
Great.
A bridge with a fast-talking shyster slash salesman dangling from it. Mm-hmm. Still trying to make a buck on my recently cleared name?
Nah, I sold all that junk to that Dooro sap. I've moved on to the next trial of the century. Flotsam Island versus LeChuck and the Voodoo Lady.
Yeah, how are sales going now?
Great! People can't get enough of the Voodoo Lady's murky moral ambiguity, mysterious unexplored backstory, and her ample...
La 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 la, I'm not listening, la la la...
Voodoo charms. And as for LeChuck, well, let's just say the lady pirates love, love, love a tale of redemption. The whole bad boy made good angle.
Have the Voodoo Lady and LeChuck been put on trial yet?
Have they? It's the trial of the century!
Wait, I thought I was the trial of the century!
Yesterday's news, Threepwood.
So, what kind of case are you building against LeChuck and the Voodoo Lady?
Oh, I'm not prosecuting them. I'm defending them.
What? Why?
Why do I do anything, Threepwood? Money, pieces of eight, filthy lucre. That Voodoo Lady babe is loaded. Funny thing, though, she only let me take the case if I defend LeChuck, too.
Funny like a peg leg. What kind of souvenirs could you possibly be making out of the Voodoo Lady and LeChuck?
Oh, ye of little faith! Feast your eyes on the all-new People vs. LeChuck and the Voodoo Lady collection!
What's this?
It's a little decorative pin I've whipped up.
Trial of the Century 2, Electric Voodoo Loop.
We're still working on a title.
What's that one?
That's our Cursed Cutlass of Kafloo LeChuck doll. Press the button for its special transforming glow.
What's happening?
It's a little bright.
Yeah, we're still working out a few kinks.
What's that?
It's my entrancing Voodoo Lady dashboard good luck charm.
Disturbing.
On second thought.
Say no more.
I don't suppose you'd be willing to sell me your eye-bending jacket.
Give up my jacket? That'd be like Samson getting a buzz cut, or King Arthur losing Excalibur, or Bluebeard dying himself blonde.
Huh?
Without my jacket, my salesman mojo would wither away faster than a hothouse orchid in a pizza oven.
So that's a maybe? Sure you don't want to sell me your pupil-defying jacket? It's for a good cause.
This jacket stays with Stan until it literally falls off my back, Threepwood.
Have you seen my wife?
Have I? That crazy sea devil hit me up for one of my patented and perfectly passable porcelain power pirate treasure maps before hightailing it for the jungle. If we're lucky, that thing will keep her going around in circles for weeks.
I have no desire whatsoever to see Stan's living arrangements.
Oh, it's you.
Can I go back in? I think I left several useful items in there.
Court is adjourned until the new defendants prepare their cases.
What was that? Something sure shoved a short sword up his aft sail. Say there, unbiased citizen.
What do you want?
Are you as scandalized as I am by this trial?
I'm just glad that scum-sucking LeChuck and that scum-sucking Voodoo Lady will finally be brought to justice.
You suck a little scum and everyone wants your head. Have you seen my wife?
Does she have red hair, green eyes, and a mole in the shape of a cocker spaniel on her left thigh?
Yes.
Nope, haven't seen her.
See ya. The doctor is out! Out of his freaking mind, maybe.
What the? Morgan! What happened?
Went to get your hand.
You didn't have to do that.
Had to pay you back for all the trouble. Found Jacques. He told me.
What?
He told me.
What? What did the monkey tell you? Singe.
DeSinge will pay for this. It's broken. This must have been broken in the fight between Morgan and DeSinge. I hope the vole escaped. I could try to mix up those chemicals, but I'd probably just end up exploding. And not in the funny way. Lepidoptera flotsamus acceleris. Like many of its more common cousins, the sharp-toothed Flotsam Island moth has a penchant for gnashing on articles of clothing. Where Flotsamus acceleris differs is in the pain of its bites, which can be quite annoying, and the rapidity of its meals. A swarm of flotsam moths can strip a man down to his undergarments in mere seconds, assuming the notoriously finicky moths approve of his wardrobe, of course. Vampiridae flotsimus sucrosus, the flotsam jungle firefly, are a common sight in Flotsam's jungles, which they never leave. Although possessing no natural enemies, the flotsimus sucrosus has a notorious sweet tooth, drawing it inexorably to bodies of sugar water. It looks like DeSinge is using my hand to make something called the jus de vie. The Vakalian wind control device? What is that creep doing with it now? Did DeSinge murder you too? Darn, no more bananas. Curse you, banana god! It'd take a 7-year correspondence course in mad sciencing before I'd even have a hope of fixing that thing. I bet there's nothing in there that can help bring Morgan back. It's locked! Oh, no! This is where the Marquis keeps all the severed limbs of the pirates he's operated on. Hey, you never know when a sack of severed legs is gonna come in handy. Or footy, as the case may be. Sorry.